Electronic mobility is one of the emerging and growing industries in the world, with the current value estimated at $15 trillion. Uganda is seeking to have a piece of this cake by seizing the opportunities that come with the growing industry, one of which is the establishment of the public charging infrastructure.
Just like the tariff they give to street lighting, which is called 50, we've asked ERA to consider looking into a special tariff. Of course, in as much as it can also be the same tariff as street lighting, but one which would really make charging a preferred, form of, mobility. Yeah.
Okay. What tariff are you using currently, and what difference with this new tariff that you're requesting for
later? Now we are using wherever our chargers are installed. If it's an industrial facility, we use the same. If it's a domestic, but of course we don't have any chargers installed in a domestic setting, so right now we are using an industrial tariff.
But these are still facing hurdles that need to be eliminated. Despite its potential, e-mobility viability in Uganda has been called into question over lack of requisite infrastructure like charging stations that Kira Motors say need incentives to attract investors.
Yeah, a tariff is informed by a number of things. One, as a regulator, we balance the interests of different stakeholders, but we must also ensure that the sector has adequate revenue to meet the costs of generating, transmitting, and distributing electricity. So we shall do a study, and we shall come up with a decision as a regulator. But we can't straight away say we are giving them the equivalent of street lighting.
This was during a fact-finding visit by the Electricity Regulatory Authority Board to Kira Motors in Chinja Industrial Park. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.